I've had this dream from a tender age, calling my name on the Opry stage. I can hear it sing loud and clear, 200 miles and I'll be there. I've been living on the wrong side of Memphis, really breaking away this time. Full tank of gas and a 69 Tempest, taking me to that Nashville sign. Yes, I've been living on the wrong side of Memphis, gonna bronze these blue suede shoes, these cowboy boots, getting kinda restless, ain't got a single thing to lose.
No sweeter sound in country music than that voice right there. Trisha Yearwood, everybody. Welcome to Opry Live. Here we are. Hello, friends. It's Bobby Bones. Hey, quick bit of news that we're excited about. For those of you watching the Opry on Dish Network, Circle Network is now available on Dish 24/7. So head over to channel 370 and you'll find all kinds of great Circle shows, I promise you. You're going to love what you find over there. Well, this is a very special night for everyone here. The backstage area is buzzing because tonight Carly Pearce is being inducted as an official member of the Opry. To make this night super special for Carly, Trisha has teamed up with the Queen Bee of the Opry stage and backstage, Jeannie Seeley. And let me tell you, for a country music artist, this is pretty much up there with the biggest moments of life. It's going to be awesome. So much female firepower tonight. So, we're going to get back to it. This is a very special night for me, for you, for Carly. But first, here once again is Trisha Yearwood.
Good evening. Welcome to the Grand Ole Opry. It is... I've not been out here in quite some time, and it's such an honor always to play this hallowed ground, standing on this little piece of wood, and we are so honored that you're here with us tonight. We got a lot of really good stuff. We had a really fun rehearsal this afternoon, so there's a lot of really fun stuff in store tonight. So just thank you for being here. We're going to do some songs that hopefully you know. Thank you. I love you, too. That's my sister. this next song is a song that I recorded back in 1992 with my friend Don Henley. Just going to drop that name real quick. The song is called Walk Away Joe. Mama told her, baby girl, take it real slow. Girl told her mama, hey, I really gotta go. He's waiting in the car. And mama said, girl, you won't get far. Thus are the dreams of an average Jane. 90 miles an hour down a lover's lane. On a tank of dreams. Oh, if she could've only seen. But fate's got cards that it don't wanna show. And that boy's just a walk away Joe, born to be a leaver, tell you from the word go. Destined to deceive her, he's a wrong kind of paradise. She's gonna know it in a matter of time. That boy's just a walk away Joe. Now just a little while into Abilene. Pulls into a station and he robs it clean. She's waiting in the car. Oh, underneath the Texaco star. She only wanted love, didn't bargain for this. She can't help but love him for the way he is. She's only 17. And there ain't no reasoning. So she rides this ride as far as it can go. Cause that boy's just a walk-away Joe. Born to be a leaver, tell you from the word go. Destined to deceive her, he's a wrong kind of paradise. She's gonna know it in a matter of time. It's just a walk away, too soon, and reaches for his arm. But she'll just keep reaching on. For the cold hard truth revealed what it had known. That boy's just a walk away girl. Born to be a leaver, tell you from the word go. Deceiver, he's a wrong kind of paradise. But it was just another lesson in life. That boy was a walk away Joe. Oh yeah, all he was a walk away Joe.
Tonight's Opry performance is in association with Shriners Hospitals for Children.
It's a very special night here at the Opry. I'm glad you guys are watching. This is one of the most fantastic nights for someone in the crowd, for someone performing, but mostly for the person being inducted, which is Carly Pearce. Just to give you guys a little background of what's happening behind the scenes. Like, it's always a big deal when someone's inducted. Luckily for me, I've been able to be a part of a few of these. I was here for Chris Jansen, who's a big buddy of mine. And so, you know, the person feels very special because you come in and everybody sent you flowers. Like, as soon as I came in back in the artist entrance, there are flowers everywhere, and they're all for Carly. And it's almost like when you see on a TV show somebody that's way too rich gets way too many Valentine's flowers. That's kind of what it looks like. But it's from a lot of different people in the country music community. So I walked in early this afternoon. We were getting ready for the show here tonight. And you start to see, like, some of Carly's family. You start to see some of her record label people. You start to see, then I saw Trisha come. And Trisha Yearwood and I are very friendly. And so the room starts to buzz a little bit more. And there's a huge reception area that, not just normal Opry reception, because there's an area back over there too, but there's food. There's fancy people walking around with, like, trays of food. Passing. It's a very, it's like prom, basically. And Carly Pearce is the queen tonight. So you guys are going to get to actually see her induction, which is super cool, especially for somebody who loves the Opry as much as Carly does. Backstage, you know, other people start showing up because Trisha's here. Her husband, Mr. Yearwood, you may know him as Garth. Garth is hanging out back there supporting Trisha. Also, Clay Walker, who was playing earlier in the show, who's not on the TV broadcast, but Clay Walker was also hanging out back there. So for me, I'm just geeking out like crazy because I love Clay Walker. Obviously, I love Garth Brooks, love Trisha Yearwood. Very excited to see Carly Pearce tonight. So this is a very special show that you guys are watching. You know, it's rare that you get to see an actual full induction with a full crowd, which is something that's very special too, because obviously we did this show, you know, me and you, most of the time, there was nobody in this room. So we're all back tonight. It's a very special night. And to have, think about this, you're getting inducted into the Opry. Dolly says, hey, come be a member, invites you. And then Trisha actually inducts you. That's pretty cool, and that's what you guys are getting to watch tonight. So I'm super pumped to be with you guys. The whole night's going to be awesome. This is not the last you're going to hear from me, but I got to go over and do the TV stuff now. So hang out for 1 second, guys. I got to, like, get my shirt straight up. Hey, everybody. Welcome back to Opry Live. I'm Bobby Bones. You know what one of the best things about country music is? It's the community, because it is a community. Everybody's rooting for everyone else, like tonight. Backstage is filled with people here to cheer on Carly Pearce on her big night. So what is Carly doing? Cooking up something to make it special for you. I got no idea what it is, but I'm not going to keep you waiting. Here is Carly Pearce.
Carly and I are here to celebrate both a special anniversary and a significant achievement for one of your most iconic songs. <laughs> 30 years ago tonight, August 3rd, 1991, She's in Love with the Boy was number one on Billboard's Hot Country Songs chart. But that's not all. Today, August 3rd, 2021, She's in Love with the Boy is the most listened to country song by a female artist in the history of MRC data, which provides radio monitoring for all of Billboard's charts. So, congratulations.
You gotta take a photo. Okay.
Okay, this was not in the plan. This was not in the rehearsal. I'm sorry, I'm speechless. I had no idea any of that stuff. I didn't know. I knew it was 30 years since She's Love the Boy was a single, but thank you. There's some people here tonight. My family's here. Scott Borchetta, who took this song to radio to get him to play it, is here tonight. So there's a lot of people listening at home who were involved in this album. And Johnny, original band member, you played this song when it first went on the radio. So, it's not good form to cry in false eyelashes, so I'm gonna try to get it together and just say thank you. Thank you to you guys. Thank you to everybody who called in to ask for this song to be played on the radio. And I never, ever get tired of singing this song because it's a great story song about how nobody's ever good enough for daddy's little girl. When I'm on the Opry, I always play this song for Porter Wagner, who was the gentleman who asked me to be, who inducted me when I became a member of the Grand Ole Opry 20 years ago. So this will always be for Porter. He always said, sing the one that brung you. So for Porter and for all of you and for the Opry, thank you so much. Here is She's in Love with the Boy.
Katie's sitting on her old front porch, watching the chickens peck the ground. There ain't a whole lot going on tonight in this one horse town. Over yonder, coming up the road in a beat up Chevy truck, her boyfriend Tommy is laying on the horn, splashing through the mud and the muck. Brains, he got the short end of the stick. Katie's young and big, she just don't care. She'd follow Tommy anywhere. She's in love with the boy.
Special night here at the Opry, obviously. Carly Pearce is getting inducted. Trisha Yearwood, who I'm watching the monitor. I see her back behind me. She should be making her way over here. I can see her over my shoulder. Let's watch together and see if Trisha, oh, here she comes. Ladies and gentlemen, Trisha Yearwood. And they're handing her a microphone. There she is. Hello, Trisha.
Hi, buddy.
Let me ask you, did you know they were going to present you with that? Are you sure?
I'm sure.
Okay.
I didn't like surprises. I was totally surprised.
You were?
I totally was.
You know we're on right now.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hi, everybody. No, I had no idea, honestly.
I would think that you were of that stature that you would know something was up.
I'm going to hurt somebody. Well, you know what? I was asked to induct Carly Pearce tonight, and this is the first time I've ever inducted anybody.
Is that right?
First time. So I've been so focused on that I honestly just didn't. Somebody told me today that this is the day, the anniversary of the number one. And I still was like, oh, that's cool. Like, I just
did you know it was the most played female
no.
ever?
No. But I'm going to tell everybody. That's going to be on a t-shirt.
I'm going to talk about my radio show tomorrow, too.
Please.
Don't think I'm not going to.
I'm totally. That's going to be on a t-shirt. It's going to be in my introduction from now on.
Well, congratulations. I know you have some big work to do tonight, but you know I love you.
I love you, too.
Congratulations.
And congrats on the wedding.
Thank you very much. I'll talk to you
Thank
soon.
Thank you. Thank you.
There she is, Trisha Yearwood. She did come over here, as always. Like, I'll tell you later about how nice Trisha and her husband are, like in real life. You always wonder if like your heroes are really nice. I'll give you some good stories coming up in the next little break there. For those of you who watch the Opry show on Dish Network, you will love this because the Circle Network, the whole network, is now available 24/7 on Dish. There you go, on the screen now. Channel 370 on Dish. If you have Dish, all the time, there's all kinds of good shows. Big Kenny's got a garage show, Talking Circles, Clint Black, who's one of the funniest country stars you'll ever meet. It's all up there. Dish Channel 370, and you'll find all of the other great Circle Network shows, not just the Opry, but so many more. So just very grateful that you guys are watching us and we're expanding and getting country music out to everybody. So we're here tonight. We're getting really close to the big moment. And so as you can hear and as you can see, the crowd is full. And it is, you know, packed all the way up. It, like, there is not an empty seat in the place tonight, which is fantastic to see. We're going to the television, so I'm going to have to straighten my clothes out. You guys get to watch the awkwardness here. I got 7 seconds till I go live on TV. Let me get back on my mark here. I'm gonna get moving over my mark. Hey everybody, welcome back to Opry Live. I'm Bobby Bones. Remember what I said earlier about how great the country music community is? Well, for members of the Opry, multiply that by 100, carry the one, multiply it again. That's what lies ahead for Carly. And right now, we're going to see a shiny example of that. Sharing a little bit of that Opry member love, here is Opry member herself, Trisha Yearwood.
I am honored tonight to get to introduce this next artist performing. One of the coolest things about being a member of the Grand Ole Opry is the friends that you make, and I love this next performer. She will celebrate 54 years as a Grand Ole Opry member next month, and she's the real deal. Also, not to be outdone, she was just recently awarded an honorary doctorate by LMU. So please, ladies and gentlemen, give an Opry welcome to Dr. Jeannie Seeley.
Don't regret one single step we've made. We're taking it slow, 'cause we both know that's the way to make love stay. People who rush in find it's a crush when it don't turn out like it should. So we'll stay where we are, 'cause we like it so far. So far, so good. We both feel the passion inside, and our love is easy to see. Taking one step at a time, we'll know if it's meant to be. 'Cause people who rush in find it's a crush when it don't turn out like it should. So we'll stay where we are, 'cause we like it so far. So far, so at a time, we'll know if it's meant to be. 'Cause people who rush in find it's a crush when it don't turn out like it should. So we'll stay where we are, 'cause we like it so far. So far, so
thank you. What a great night. She held up her sign saying, just married, as I'm singing, so far, so good. They're at the Grand Ole Opry. Thank you so much for being here. It's great to be here with you tonight. And I got a special song that I want to do for you. And I'm going to brag just a little bit. I'm number 71 in the national charts with my single record. Who gets that at 81 years old? I mean, come on. I'm just so blessed. Thank you so much. This is a song that a friend of mine, Ron Harmon, found in a journal where Dottie West had started writing this song. As most of you know, Dottie and I were very dear friends, and Ron took it to Bobby Tomberlin and Grand Ole Opry star Steve Warner to finish it, and I truly think they finished it the way Dottie would, and I think she's celebrating with us tonight, too. We hope you like it. It's called I Just Go On Living, if you can call it that. I wake up every morning, pour my coffee, gather my things, jump right in that same old traffic. Welcome to my routine. And then at work I hear a voice, how you doing? Someone asks. I just go on living, if you can call it that. 5 o'clock rolls around, I meet up with some friends. I try to smile, but all the while it's just pretend. Another glass of wine, a few more jokes, I try to laugh. I just go on living, if you can call it that. It's like I'm stranded out on the ocean, and you're not here to pull me through. I'm like a child who's lost her way, just can't find her way back. I just go on living, you can call it that.
Hey, I'm Blake Shelton.
I'm Dennis Quaid.
Hi, I'm Sarah Evans.
This is Luke Combs.
Hi, I'm Kevin Moe.
I'm Ashley McBride.
I'm Trace Adkins.
What's up? I'm Darius Rucker.
Join me in the circle on Dish.
Get in the circle with Dish Channel 370. Country plays here.
Well, the place is a buzz. Jeannie Silly. How great is she? And you know, they call her the Queen of the Opry and also the Queen of Backstage because, you know, I think I've played the Opry 15 or 16 times myself, either doing music or comedy, or I come up and do this show, and Jeannie's always here, and she's always the most welcoming and the greatest person. You know, I mentioned earlier, you know, when Trisha was up here and I was talking with her, like, it's crazy to me, even at this stage of my career and whatever success that I've had on radio or TV or whatever, when you meet extremely famous and successful people and they're really cool. It's rare. Usually they're very guarded. Sometimes they can be nice, but be guarded because everybody's trying to get stuff from them. Sometimes they can just not be nice. And so you just don't want to hang around them at all. But that being said, like, when you meet Trisha, if you didn't know she was famous, you just wouldn't know she was famous. She is that disarming, that cool of a person. Anytime that we've done stuff together, like, she came over to my house and we did a thing once, and then she brought treats. Like, who brings treats? Same for Garth. Garth is the probably, even though he is the most famous, which, by the way, you may not know this, but Garth is the number one selling American artist of all time. Of all time, right? The only person that, like, surpasses him is the Beatles. Obviously, they're not American, but he's that big and famous. And if you see Garth out and about, he's just in a sweatshirt, and he's just a normal guy. And he is, again, the most famous country music artist of forever. But it's just cool to know. And I would tell you the truth. Actually, I just wouldn't tell you anything at all. I'm not lying to you, but if they were real jerks, I just wouldn't say anything about it at all. But know from my heart here that two of the coolest, nicest people are Trisha Yearwood. And you won't see Garth tonight because he's backstage just supporting Trisha. And all of this, whenever he's like, I'm Mr. Yearwood, like, that's really him in real life, too. So just know from your friend Bobby here that they really are the coolest people. And you're about to watch Trisha induct Carly. I didn't know Trisha had never inducted anyone before. That's pretty cool. And if you're just turning us on, you may also know, not know it or not have seen that She's in Love with a Boy is the number one most played female song of all time. It was awarded to Trisha tonight. And I was like, are you sure you didn't know that? She did not. So welcome to the show if you're just turning us on. If you've been here, you're waiting like I am for an induction of the Grand Ole Opry. It doesn't happen but a few times a year. And me and you, we're here to see it. So we'll get back in. I'm going to go over to Jeannie Seely. She's about to take over on the microphone. So thank you guys for watching. A very special night. Let's go back over to the stage right now. Thanks for watching the Opry, guys.
I have had the pleasure of introducing this young lady on this stage many times, but I'll tell you, never as important as tonight is. I have watched her career since I first was aware of her as a teenager down at Dollywood many years ago. She has all the obvious things, the good looks, the talents, and everything to go with it. However, she had one extra thing not everybody has. She has that determination and that dedication. And she has the strongest work ethic of anybody I've ever known in my life, I think. She set her sights. And no matter what, she never strayed from that path one minute. Her sights were set here at the Grand Ole Opry. And ladies and gentlemen, she's here. Would you welcome Carly Pearce?
It's all on me. It's my mistake. I said I don't love you a little too late, but I guess there ain't ever a right time, and I don't know why it's called a goodbye. So go run my name into the ground, tell everyone you know just how I slammed the door on our forever. But I promise you it's for the my heart.
How we doing, Opry? I can't start crying yet. I'm gonna save my tears for a minute, but something very, very awesome is about to happen. I grew up loving females of the 90s. Female voices that when you turned on the radio, you just knew who they were. I'm a sucker for tone of voices. And I don't think that anybody is better than Trisha Yearwood. And my mom and dad are here, and I'm pretty sure that they would tell you that I probably had a lot of concerts for my stuffed animals in my bedroom when I was a little girl, singing this song, trying to pretend that I was Trisha. So I'm going to sing a song that I love so much. I know all of you love it so much. And I hope that maybe I can like convince somebody who's backstage to come out with me. I don't know.
If I had to live without you, what kind of life would that be? Oh, night, I need you in my arms, need you to hold. You're my world, my heart, my soul. If you ever leave, well, baby, you would take away stage, the beautiful Miss Trisha Yearwood.
Without you, there'd be no sun in my sky. There would be no love in my life. There'd be no world left for me. And I, well, baby, I don't know what I would do. I'd be lost if I lost you.
It's a historic night here at the Grand Ole Opry, isn't it? Huh? As we officially add a new member to our family. By now, you've likely seen how much the invitation of an Opry membership means to Carly Pearce. And when the legendary Dolly Parton surprised her with that invitation a few weeks ago, Dolly, who's been here for 50 years as a member. In just a few short years of Opry appearances, Carly has played the show more than 80 times, all while amassing career milestones, including critical acclaim, sold-out shows, prestigious awards, and number one records. Tonight, the wait is over, and one of the greatest milestones in any career is about to happen in that circle of wood center stage. The Opry member presenting Carly's Opry Member Award tonight is one of the most respected artists of this era and a hero to Carly and so, so many others. She was inducted into the Opry by Porter Wagoner in 1999, and tonight she is back to officially welcome Carly Pearce. Back to center stage, Trisha Yearwood.
Carly, I need you to stand in this circle. It's important. I want to tell you that I'm honored to be asked. This is the first time I've ever been asked to induct someone, and I got to meet you at an award show several years ago, and I liked you immediately. Your kindness, you're a good egg, but you also have those pipes. You are truly a talent, and just congratulations on all your success. I do want to say that this place, the Grand Ole Opry, is a special place, and when I was a little girl, I just saw myself up here on this stage. This is what I wanted, so I get it. This is not a club that you can just join. This is a very special family that you have to be invited into. And when they ask you to become a member, it means that they know that you get it. You know, you're doing something great, but you also get what came before. And so it is with just joy and so much pride, and I represent everybody here at the Grand Ole Opry and all your fans, to say, Carly Pearce, you are now officially a member of the Grand Ole Opry. Congratulations.
No one who knows me knows that that's not shocking that I just hit that. Oh my goodness. Oh my gosh, I did it again. Let me put it back here. I love you too. There are a lot of things that I could say, and I've tried to think about how to sum up what this means to me. And the best way I know how to describe it is when I was a little girl, I dreamt of country music. And I dreamt of singing on the stage. And my grandma, my mamma, and Papa Pearce, I always told them that if I ever made it here, they would be front row. And they didn't get to see that happen, but I really do genuinely feel like they're here with me tonight. And I know that this was as much my dream as it was theirs. And I've seen a lot of my dreams come true over the last few years, but I think that what makes this place so special, what makes this family such a place that I wanted to be a part of, is because you can have hit records, you can sell out shows, you can be on award shows, but all of that can fade. And this is something that I will have forever, and a place that I can come to, and a stage that I can sing on, and a circle that I can stand in, and a family that I can be a part of, and that can never be taken away from me. And that's super special to me. And all I've ever wanted to do in the entire world is sing country music, and the Grand Ole Opry let a 25-year-old Airbnb cleaner, yes, that's me, stand on this stage before I ever had a record deal, so I kind of feel like I've grown up in this industry over the last 5 years with them. Grand Ole Opry, this isn't just another feather in my cap. This isn't another accolade. This isn't another thing to add to my wall. This is a promise to all of you and to this organization that I will do my due diligence as a Grand Ole Opry member to make sure that the circle is never unbroken. God bless you guys. Thank you.
Well, it's a pretty great speech. Carly Pearce just got inducted into the Grand Ole Opry. You hear the crowd now. They are still cheering for her. What a great performance, right? Let's first reflect on, you know, having Carly and Trisha sing that song, and then the speech and the emotion. And the crowd got up, and the crowd got sad, and the crowd got up again. Like, that's what the Grand Ole Opry is all about. So I'm really glad that you guys were here tonight to watch something very, very special. Because, like I said earlier, that doesn't happen a whole lot. It's not like they're just throwing out invitations and inductions to be members in the Grand Ole Opry. So congratulations to Carly. I know that that was super important to her. I mean, heck, I remember when she first started playing the Opry 5 years ago. She mentioned it there. She didn't have a record deal. You know, she was playing, looking for anyone to notice her, and the Opry opened their arms and said, hey, come play on this stage. And from the day that she started playing here to now, I mean, you've kind of seen her transform into a superstar artist. So from me to you, Carly Pearce, congratulations. That is fantastic. I'll also say this, we're wrapping up the show. Like, I get this big packet of notes here that you see. Sometimes I hold, I rarely go to them. But our executive producer, Brett, always writes a ton of notes on this. I never read them, and I feel in a way this is his induction to me respecting his notes. So I'd like to read you a few notes that Brett wrote me tonight. Number one, Trisha Yearwood, info. Hometown, Monticello, Georgia. Full name, Patricia Lynn Yearwood. That's two notes that Brett put for me in case I had nothing to say tonight. Trisha, fun facts. Her mother's name is Gwendolyn Yearwood, who was a school teacher. She performed the closing ceremonies at the 1996 Summer Olympics, which were in Atlanta. And then one final fun fact from Brett. One of her interesting collaborations was Don Henley, Walk Away Joe in 1992. So Brett, for me to you, this is your induction into the Cool Kids Club. I now used your notes. Sometimes you just have too many stories to come out here and tell. That's what I feel like every night when I get to be on this stage and talk to you guys. And so you're going to love what you're going to see for the rest of the night. I got to go back over to the TV part of the show. I'll put my notes down. They kind of don't look professional on TV. But just so glad that you're here with us to be able to do this. And you got to see history being made. If you're like me and you love the Opry, this is something that you can always remember, to see Carly Pearce get inducted into the Grand Ole Opry by Trisha Yearwood. Okay, got like 10 seconds before I go back to TV. Thank you, guys. Thank you, thank you, thank you. All right. Welcome back to Opry Live. Carly Pearce's induction as an Opry member. Wow. Thanks to Trisha Yearwood and Jeannie Seeley, and congratulations to Carly Pearce. You're fantastic. I only get to say this once. With our first solo performance as an Opry member, here once again is Carly Pearce. Good night, everybody.
So I released a song today with one of my heroes, Patti Loveless, and I wrote this song with Shane McAnally, who's here tonight, my producer, and we were just talking about all of the ways that, as a girl from Kentucky, I feel like my grandma made me understand that if you were gonna sing country music, you had to love Loretta. But over the last few years, I have really understood the way that Loretta wrote songs and why she wrote them the way that she did. So I'm gonna sing you one that I wrote for Loretta. Never met her. She did tweet me though.
Dear Miss Loretta, I ain't ever met ya, but I'm lonely tonight, and I just bet you might have some wisdom to pull off that shelf. Your songs were all fun till I lived them myself. I ain't a coal miner's daughter, but my grandmother was. Must be whiskey in the water, must be bourbon in the blood. I'm a long way from Kentucky, but the hurting's the same. Now I know why you sang that way. What ended up tough started out broken. What ended up lost started out hoping. A lifetime of pain was 3 minutes long, and you weren't ashamed when the world sang along. I ain't a coal miner's daughter, but my grandmother was. Must be whiskey in the water, must be bourbon in the blood. I'm a long way from Kentucky, but the hurting's the same. Now I know why you sing that way. And dear Miss Loretta, we both grew up too fast, and I wish you could tell me how you made it last. I ain't a coal miner's daughter, but I've sung it all my life. I ain't been a widow, but I've been an ex-wife. And I hear your truth, and I feel your pain. Now I know why you sing that way. Yeah, I know why you sing that way.
Thank you.
This literally is the best night of my life. Grand Ole Opry, is it anybody's first time here? Awesome. I feel so lucky for what's about to happen up here. I am neighbors with Jeannie Seeley, and Jeannie used to get me in on her backstage list before I ever had a record deal to see Carrie Underwood. And Jeannie has become such a pillar for me in this industry, and somebody that I look up so much to as an artist, as a woman in country music. And Trisha Yearwood obviously is one of my biggest influences in the entire world. And so you're about to see three generations of female Opry members come together. So please welcome to the stage Miss Jeannie Seeley and Trisha Yearwood.
Congratulations to you. And what you said was just perfect. Was she not perfect? And her dedication is just...
And Jeannie and I were saying, it's easy to say the things we said about you when it's true. And just, you're the real deal. Congratulations.
Opry member.
Thanks, guys.
And she cares about you. And we all care about you. We appreciate you.
I feel like I'm prom queen or something.
What is this about?
Oh, I'm so excited. Okay, let's sing.
Let me be the first to say welcome home to the Grand Ole Opry, okay, because it's home now. Should we keep her?
I think we should keep her, yeah.
Please keep me. I'll wash the toilets and clean the floors. And
you come out and hit the high note on how to live every night. I'll just say, Carly, hit it.
I'll just come out.
You had the idea for us to do this together, which I love, this three generations, and you should introduce this song because you're the one who came up with the idea.
Yes.
Well, I thought it might be appropriate to do this and pay a nod to Kitty Wells and the generation before ours. And so it's a very special, and just for me personally, I have to tell you, I'm wearing Jan Howard's jacket, Gene Shepherd's ring, and of course, I sang the Dottie West song earlier. So, girls, the circle will not be broken. We are here,
we're
okay?
To be part of it.
You ready?
Ooh.
can't believe that you still love me. It's leaving me alone and so blue. I'll always dream I'll never
Grand Ole Opry.